Good morning, guys. Thank you for joining me. Looks like it's going to be another busy day with earthquakes and volcanic eruptions, etc., around the world. At 11:46 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 5.1 earthquake off the coast of Petrolia, California. 573 people took the time to report feeling this earthquake. Using Google Earth, here we are at the Mendocino Triple Junction. Over here on the right, there is a capacity stress has built for a magnitude 8 or greater earthquake. This area has had large earthquakes in the past. 1992, there was a magnitude 7.2. And I believe that earthquake actually created a small tsunami. This is an area where the San Andreas Fault and the Juan de Fuca fracture zone is colliding. Off on the west, we have the Gorda Plate. Let me bring this out a little bit more so you can see it. The Gorda Plate is being compressed, squished, and slowly moving southeast. This is all part of the ancient Farallon Plate, which I've talked a lot about in the recent months. It is slowly sliding underneath, subducting, all the way to Lake Tahoe. Felt reports with the intensity level according to color. We got Yuba City here, Vacaville, Concord, Tracy, San Mateo, Oakland, San Francisco, all had felt reports. There is even a report all the way up by Grants Pass, Oregon, of a felt report. So here we have the intensity level map. They gave it an intensity level of 4. There is a lot up by Redding and Red Bluff and Sacramento, the Bay Area, intensity level of 2 and 3. Intensity level 3, it says here, felt quite noticeably indoors, especially on the upper floors of buildings. Many people do not recognize that it was an earthquake. Standing automobiles may rock slightly and vibrations likely of a passing truck. And then 4, it says during the day felt indoors by many. Well, it happened at night there, just before midnight, by many. Outdoors by few. At night, some are awakened. Dishes, windows, doors disturb. Walls make creaking sounds. Sensation like a heavy truck striking the building. Standing automobiles rock noticeably. USGS censors the felt reports that are sent in. EMSC, they always post them, but there's nothing posted on EMSC of these felt reports. We got one here of green. But we got, there's some dark blues. So the one report, which would be green, is an intensity level of 5. It looks like it says Red Crest near Bull Creek and Larrabee Creek. I suppose the intensity would depend on the type of rock formation, be it, or even sand, sediment, how strong the shaking would be. Now, intensity level 5, it says some dishes, windows, crack plaster, unstable objects turned over, disturbance of trees, poles, and other tall objects sometimes are noticed, it says. Pendulum clocks may stop. So did they have damage? It says crack plaster in a few places. Did you have damage? And like I said, USGS does not post what people actually experienced during the earthquake. I wish they would. Just another form of censoring. Stronger shaking in this location, towards the south, it looks like, right along the border of Humboldt and Mendocino counties. And we got Red Mountain. Oh, let me bring this down here. You see the darker colors. Let me bring it out a little bit for you. Fort Bragg. They put the blocks right on top of the names of the different locations. Oh, it's felt in Lakeport, Clear Lake, California. What else we got here? Cache Creek, Lake Berryessa, Napa, Petaluma, Vallejo, Santa Rosa, Oakland, San Francisco. Yeah, it was felt pretty strong there in Oakland, it looks like. Hardly felt in Sunnyvale. As you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. There was a report on another earthquake where they were saying that it was actually higher, maybe a 30% chance. But like I said, this area has stress built up where it's capable of having a magnitude 8. Are you prepared? Let's see, we got a 5.2. When was that? That was on March 18th of last year. So I know many of you follow me. Did you feel it? And how did your pets react prior, during, and after? Which direction did the motion feel like? How long did the earthquake last? Those are all the little details that I would love to have. Please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.